And now we come to the I'd Like to Be portion of our program. Here to play I'd Like to Be with us tonight is the famous singer and motion picture actor, Mr. Dick Haymes. Richard.
Thank you.
What are you doing in town?
Well, I'm going to put my cheetahs on first thing.
Attaboy. Join the fraternity.
Yes. Hello, Meredith.
Doesn't that do something for him?
Garry.
Tell me something. What are you doing in town, Richard?
No, I don't know. I came to New York to say hello to all my friends. I'll be here for a couple of weeks.
Good.
Saying hello to you.
Well, I'm delighted to hear it.
And of course, all our friends.
We want the panel to go to work on Richard Haymes. And before the show started, Dick told us who he might like to be just in fun, of course, if he weren't himself. Panel, we'll see if you can determine who that person is in just a moment. But before we do that, here once again is our lovely Jean Sullivan to tell you about a wonderful new pantry idea.
Friends, if you want to save yourself a lot of hard work and yet serve a good dinner in a few minutes, build a Swanson 10-minute shelf in your pantry. Then, no matter what time you come home, just reach up to your 10-minute shelf for a can of Swanson new boneless chicken thick fricassee that takes only 10 minutes to fix. Just pour the contents into a pot and heat. There are no bones, just thick slices of tender chicken cooked in real butter gravy. After heating, pour over toasted frozen waffles. Top with more waffles and cover with remaining fricassee. Now, you may use biscuits or rice instead of waffles, but in every case, you will have a hearty chicken dinner in approximately 10 minutes. So, friends, remember, for convenience, for economy, and for downright good eating, build yourself a 10-minute shelf stocked with the three kinds of Swanson chicken fricassee. Regular chicken fricassee, fricassee of chicken wings, and new boneless chicken fricassee. All tender, tasty chicken in rich butter gravy. Also easy to fix, so delicious to eat. Remember, Swanson, the name of the finest chicken in the land.
Right you are. Happy you will be when you have that beautiful Swanson right on your dinner table. Well, now we're set to play I'd Like to Be. Our panel's going to try to find out who it is Dick Haymes would like to be. Let's let our home audience see that famous name. Panel, we play the same as before. The loser's checks will go to Dick Haymes' favorite charity. Suppose we start this one off with Garry.
Again?
Yeah.
Because you won.
Because this is my reward for winning. I wish I'd lost. Tell me, Richard, this fellow that you would like to be, is he living?
Yes.
Yes, you call that
you
living.
You seem somewhat dubious. I mean, is he living?
Yes.
He is living?
Yes.
Assuming that many actors would sometime like to be other actors, is this fella, is he tall, dark, and handsome?
Well, no.
Oh, yes. Well, is he then the big, rugged, outdoor kind of guy that women fight over type?
The women fight over type?
You know, the kind of big, rugged.
Well, let me put it this way. If I were he, I would like to be.
Why say? Why?
Perfectly valid. No, he is not the type that women...
Yeah, I think so. You think they'd fight over him?
Well, is he the rugged outdoor type? I'm thinking of a Joel McRae type of guy.
No.
What other type? Is he the suave, sophisticated type?
No.
Not suave and sophisticated, huh?
No.
But this guy is an actor. Well, he's in show business. Let's put it that way.
Oh, yes.
He's in show.
Yes.
Very definitely. Rugged, and he's not handsome, and he's not suave.
I didn't say he wasn't handsome.
He sounds like a big nothing. I don't... What can... Oh, wait, we've overlooked one category. A comedian. Is he a comedian?
Yes.
Is he a comedian? Well, I'll ask the same question I asked before. Got a good answer on it. Told me nothing. Is he among that group of people who we constantly refer to as our bright young comedians?
Yes, I would say so.
Just, they've been, Gary, I guess they've been calling him a bright young comedian now for about 15 years.
And he also has relatives in the audience.
Yeah, apparently.
We want to help you as much
does
as
does he have any unusual physical characteristics?
Yes.
He does. I got to be very careful how I say this because I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings, but, do people sometimes say, just kidding, just in fun, in a loving kind of way, do they say that he has a face like a monkey?
No, not that I know of.
Not that you know.
I've heard it said. Of course,
I haven't been in town.
Well, I know. The word's gotten around.
Really?
I would say it was more of a nice sort of a monkey.
Nice-looking,
you know.
A particularly nice-looking monkey.
I would agree with that.
Well, this fellow who looks like a ravishing monkey, I'll take a big guess. I've got two questions left. I'll stake one and save one. I'll tell you who I'm thinking about. Jerry Lewis.
Say, that's a pretty good guess.
Is it?
But you're wrong.
Oh, you dog. I passed that to
Joan. Joanie?
Well, of course, some of my best friends are monkeys, but not ravishing ones. Looks like a monkey. Oh, honestly.
I don't think he looks
well, a nice monkey, Joni. Haven't you ever seen him? Look, nice monkey.
A nice monkey, all right. You said he had distinguishing physical characteristics. Are these from the neck up?
Yes.
Is this man got something peculiar about his hair?
Yes.
Yeah. I'll have to restrict...
Does he wear a kind of a fright wig?
No.
You mean a real wig?
A fright wig.
Well, I mean, blonde curls, fright wig type.
Oh, no.
We have about...
Does he wear any toupee at all?
Well, there's a lot of talk around. No, he does not, no, and no. I would have to restrict this now to 30 seconds.
Well, you said he had distinguishing physical characteristics from the neck up. Does he have an odd-looking nose?
Well, it isn't odd.
This man is neither one thing nor another. I pass.
Meredith, I'm sorry. I'm afraid, Meredith, we won't have time to get to you. We have been so insulting.
Excuse me, may I say good evening to Dick?
How are you?
Good evening, Dick.
Oh, nice to see you.
Splendid.
Thought I told you to wait in the car. We, unfortunately, do not have time to continue. I would like you to... he would like to be Garry Moore.
Oh, no!
You don't really look like a monkey. Dick, our time is running short. I'm going to ask you to go over there, pick up three checks for $25 each for your favorite charity, and thanks so much from Swanson for playing the names the same.
Pleasure.
Good to
pleasure.
See you, Richard.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.